During the course of the competition, the judging panel often encounters teams whose unique efforts, performance, or dynamics merit recognition, yet do not fit into any of the existing award categories. Today, the judges have defined the following special award for one such deserving team.
This team consistently represented across every category: competence, innovation, quality, engineering, sportsmanship, and enthusiasm. The judges went nuts over their performance at the competition. They sure aren't squirrely about embracing first principles, which is why we created the Golden Acorn Award.
And the Golden Acorn Award goes to Team 2930!
The Sonic Squirrels!
The Industrial Safety Award, sponsored by Underwriters Laboratories, is judged by our Underwriters Laboratories safety advisors, who I'd like to bring out to the field right now. Please welcome our safety advisors. This award celebrates a team that progresses beyond safety fundamentals by using innovative ways to eliminate or protect against hazards. The winning team consistently demonstrates excellence in safety through the heat of competition.
This team promotes a culture of safety in everything they do. Their safety co-captains are always available and willing to help their peers. They have been recognized as a leader in safety. Seek out safety advice from this team is like a squirrel looking for nuts.
Welcome back, Team 2930!
The Sonic Squirrels!
Saw those guys. All right, we're moving right along. This is award 11, by the way, out of 19. So we're about halfway there. We're good. The Innovation and Control Award, sponsored by Rockwell Automation, celebrates an innovative control system or application of control components to provide unique machine functions.
This team's wheels were a notch above the rest, and their performance was simply magnetic. And they easily rode their way to victory. This team doesn't horse around.
Congratulations to 3711!
The Iron Mustangs!
Yeah.
Next up, the Excellence in Engineering Award, sponsored by Delphi. This award celebrates an elegant and advantageous machine feature. The team that wins this award must be able to describe as well as demonstrate the chosen feature of their machine.
This team showed a strong and consistent design process when it came time to storm the castle and secure their hoard. They used 3D CAD, clever programming, and clear thinking in their quest to scorch the ramparts. This team used their strong engineering skills to prove that they have nothing to fear from any knights out to slay them.
The award goes to Team 1595!
The Dragons!
Our next award is the Highest Rookie Seed Award, which celebrates the highest seeded rookie team at the conclusion of the qualifying rounds. And at this competition, the award goes to Team 5920.
The Vikotics from Palouse, Washington.
Time to present our finalist and winner medals, and to join us for this, I'd like to invite the referees to the field, please. Always. The District Finalist Award celebrates the alliance that makes it to the final match of the competition. First recognizes the talent of these outstanding competitors. They were sensational, and we are proud to honor them. Please congratulate the captain of the Finalist Alliance, Team 3711.
Iron Mustangs. Issaquah Robotic Society.
I am the tiger. And the third member of the Alliance team, 29-26.
The Robo Sparks.
We now recognize the Central Washington District Event Champions. This alliance rose to the challenge of First Stronghold and will now raise a blue winner's banner in their home kingdom. Please join us in celebrating their achievements. Congratulations to our winning alliance captain, Team 1983!
Skunkworks Robotics! The Cyborgs! The CV Bearbots.
Transmissions will resume. I try to
We're now happy to present the Rookie All-Star Award. This award celebrates the rookie team exemplifying a young but strong partnership effort, as well as implementing the mission of FIRST to inspire students to learn more about science and technology. This is not an easy challenge for a rookie team, but the judges want to recognize and reward one team that got it right.
This rookie all-star team worked cohesively both on and off the field. Their drive to succeed can be found in their DNA. Rising to the apex of every challenge, this team will be hanging around even in sub-zero temperature.
Qualifying to compete for the Rookie All-Star Award at the District Championships, our winner is Team 5803!
Apex Robotics!
Moving on, next is the Engineering Inspiration Award, which celebrates outstanding success in advancing respect and appreciation for engineering within a team's community. Inspiring others to respect science and technology requires passion, knowledge, and commitment. FIRST celebrates these qualities by presenting its Engineering Inspiration Award.
This team gets the information out, and despite their name, doesn't shy away from shining the spotlight on STEM. From conference presentations to after-school programs, summer camps, and even the county fair, this team's presence in their community is no secret.
Qualifying to compete for the Engineering Inspiration Award at District Championships, our winner is Team 4125.
Team Confidential.
Yesterday morning, we recognized those students who had been nominated for the FIRST Dean's List Semifinalist Award at this event, and our judges have chosen two of these students to move on as semifinalists to be judged at the district championship. We would now like to honor and recognize our two Dean's List semifinalists from the Central Washington event. Our last award, of course, is going to be the Chairman's Award. After the presentation of this award, we will have the Chairman's Award winning team's video. And then, as I understand it, we actually do have a highlight reel for this event as well. So we will show both of those videos after we have presented our last award. We do not? Alec told me otherwise. We do not. There may or may not be a highlight reel that we will show after we show the Chairman's Award-winning video. In the meantime, let's find out who won the big one. I'm working on it. Thank you, Aya. The Central Washington District Chairman's Award is the most prestigious award at FIRST. It honors the team that best represents a model for others to emulate and best embodies the purpose and goals of FIRST. The Chairman's Award is presented to the team judged to have had the most significant measurable impact of its partnerships among its participants and community over a sustained period, not just a single build season. The winner is able to demonstrate progress towards FIRST's mission of transforming our culture. The recipient team will be invited to the district championship where it will compete for the District Chairman's Award against the winners from all the other district qualifying events.
Taking the message of FIRST in new directions was this team's forte. Already teachers and lobbyists for the future, they supported fellow FIRST teams in capital fashion. This 10-year legacy team has become a smelly success.
Our Chairman's Award goes to Team 1983.
Skunkworks Robotics.
And if you'll direct your attention to our big screen, we'd like to present Skunkworks' Chairman's Award winning video. After these brief messages from our sponsors, who apparently do not include zip ties. Please stand by, your call is important to us and will be answered in the order in which it was received. Your approximate wait time is, ding dong, 2 minutes.
Do Industrial District of rainy South Seattle. Our shop was a teacher's classroom, and our robots was nothing more than a kit bot made of plumbing parts. We were an underfunded team in an upstart school with nothing but a dream. From day one, we have worked hand-in-hand with our school to pioneer STEM education in our district. We have used what we have learned to deliver impactful outreach to positively change our community. In the past 2 years, we have packaged over 20,000 pounds of food at Northwest Harvest, an organization that provides hunger relief in our community. What is our mission? To break down barriers in culture, access and support, and inspire and prepare students for their future in STEM careers. We break down the cultural barrier by going into communities that don't have access to STEM and showing that anyone can participate in robotics and have a lot of fun. Every month on Free First Thursdays, our students staff a hands-on robotics demonstration booth at the Museum of Flight. Every year, Skunkworks volunteers at Challenge Air, a program that gives special needs kids the opportunity to fly with private pilots. It is truly amazing to see how this flight changes their perception of what they can be. We've removed access barriers by showing kids STEM is cool and engaging them in projects that they can wrap their head, heart, and hands around. For many years, we have brought our robotics programs to libraries to engage kids in underserved communities. We have applied what we have learned at Concord International School to inspire over 500 kids and build awareness and interest in engineering. And since 2011, 600 Boys and Girl Scouts have earned a merit badge at our robotics clinics. STEM needs support. We are building the future we want by engaging legislators and business leaders to grow STEM. In our business outreach program, each student meets with local business leaders to excite them about STEM and grow partnerships that support FIRST. One of these student business contacts grew from a request for team support to Tableau Software seeking our help to grow them into a national FIRST sponsor. In 2016, Skunkworks organized FIRST Day. We trained 23 FIRST teams to advocate in Olympia and personally contacted two-thirds of state legislators. Bringing it all together, a great example of our efforts to break down barriers is our smelly competition. We worked with our business partners and Boys and Girls Clubs in King County to train coaches, prepare teams, and host a simple game where kids had hands-on fun with robots and can see their future in STEM.
How has doing this competition changed what you want to be when you grow up?
I just really wanted to be like work in like an office, like a news person. And once I learned about like robotics, I wanted to be an engineer and build like planes and just to help people, like get a medicine or something to cure cancer or something to help other people.
Congratulations once again, Team 1983. And we have confirmed that we do, in fact, have a highlight reel to show. So we will roll that right now.
Oh,
Well, that's our show, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to say thanks once more to all of our volunteers. Thank you to Central Washington University for hosting us. The blue truck is still in Mount Vernon. If you want more robot action, check that out. They'll be there until probably about 7 or 8 tonight, and then again tomorrow for the end of quals and playoffs. Next week, we're down in Philomath, Oregon. And then the following week, it's Auburn, Washington, and Clackamas Academy, I think, down in Oregon, leading up to the district championships in Portland. Thank you all for being here. It's been fantastic. Get home safely, and good night, everybody.
If you could please do your best to pick up in the stands after yourself. But you can leave money. It's fine. We'll pick that up later. To do.